Hello, I'm Dr. Clint Sexton with Naperville Integrated Wellness, and today I want to talk about IBS and functional bowel disorders. So IBS falls under the category of what we call a functional bowel disorder, and what we're talking about there is meaning it's just the digestive system is not working the way that it should. We don't diagnose IBS or other functional bowel disorders with a blood test or doing an x-ray or an MRI or anything like this. It's based on your symptoms. And typically, if you go in and if you had some type of study done, either colonoscopy or endoscopy, you're not really going to find anything to really explain why you're having this issue with the bowel. So I like to take functional bowel disorders and basically look at two major systems that can influence this. So one would be the nervous system. So that would include your brain, but also the whole nervous system of the gut. And then the immune system. Those two are often interfering or supporting each other. There's a third system, and that's the hormones and that's the endocrine system. Now that can play a role, and hormones can be a contributing factor. It's typically not the primary or fundamental or more of the root cause factor. We're usually going back to, again, the nervous system and the immune system. Even if you look at a lot of the medications that are used for IBS or functional bowel disorders, you're going to see that there's something that's influencing neurotransmitters, which means it's influencing the nervous system. There's not much emphasis put on the immune system simply because there aren't a lot of medications to help support the immune system. Most of the medications are designed to suppress the immune system, which, again, that doesn't really help us with the issue of these functional bowel disorders. So when we're looking at this, we want to look at the kinds of things that are going to influence the nervous system, things that are going to influence the immune system. Okay, and so things that could influence, let's say, the immune system might be the type of organisms that are living in the gut. Maybe we have an imbalance of good bacteria and bad bacteria, or an overgrowth of yeast, or maybe we have food sensitivities or food allergies, or maybe we have something called a leaky gut, or maybe we have an overgrowth of microbes in let's say, the small intestine, whereas these microbes should be down in the large intestine. That's another functional bowel issue we see, and that's called SIBO. So when we're talking about these imbalances of the gut, we need to go back and, again, look at these systems. What's going to affect the immune system? And then the nervous system. So with regard to the nervous system, sometimes we do have an imbalance of the chemistry or the neurotransmitters that affect that. But many times that can be changed by looking at different nutritional factors. Many times with IBS, we see problems with, let's say, with anxiety or other, you know, emotional or mood disorders. And so again, we're back to the nervous system, we're back to neurotransmitters again. So really the whole point is shifting our focus and looking at the two systems that really seem to play a role in this and seeing what we can do to regain greater stability to those systems so they work together more harmoniously and we start to establish function again. What I do is functional medicine, and IBS is a functional bowel disorder. So we're looking to find out what's creating that imbalance and help to correct that and create a greater stability and balance to that system. So if you'd like some more details on this, check out the blog. Thank you.